I was recently asked how you could turn $1,000 investment into $100,000 breeding snakes. So, challenge accepted. Let's see how I do. But before we get started, I want to say a couple things. Number one, I really don't breed snakes for investments anymore, but I do have a lot of background in obviously how BHB grew over the last 30 something years. So I'm going to give this a shot. Now, the other thing is, this isn't the only way that you can be successful or you could completely fail. You have to put in the work and things have to work out. So I'm just going to give you an idea of what I would do if I was starting out with $1,000 and wanted to invest and produce $100,000 worth of snakes within several years. So I would first probably buy a male lesser leopard clown ball python. Then I would buy a female spot-nosed heifer clown ball python. Now those two animals combined would be the founding stock and they would cost me right about $1,000. Now the reason that I would choose the clown ball python project to get started is it's very, very popular right now and it's in high demand. So that way when you produce babies, people are gonna wanna buy them, but it's gonna take you a couple years to raise them up to size. So again, exercise patience, right? So when you get that first breeding, you're actually gonna have an opportunity to produce a whole bunch of stuff, which are actually Batmans. And the Batmans are very, very popular and they can sell for a couple $1,000 plus. And then you start getting into the lesser leopard spot-nosed clown ball python and that can sell for up to $3,500. And then of course you're gonna produce a whole bunch of other stuff. Remember, there's gonna be a lot of clowns. There's gonna be everything that's heifer clown. So what I would do is actually hang on to all of the females in the clutch. And then I would definitely hold on to the best male in the clutch, hoping that maybe you produce that lesser leopard spot-nosed clown ball python. Use that for future breeding. So let's say you get four females that you're gonna hang on to, combinations of either het or actual clown ball pythons. Now you can sell the other males off that you produce in there because you're gonna produce some maybe lesser clowns, you're gonna produce some spot-nosed clowns, you're gonna produce some leopard clowns, stuff like that. You can actually sell those off and maybe make upwards of $10,000 on that first clutch. Then you start talking about, what do I do with that $10,000? The next thing I really want to do is actually take some of that money and breed it into banana or coral glows, right? So you could get maybe a male banana leopard clown ball python to add to the production. And this is one right here, absolutely beautiful. But having that banana gene into it, then you can start to get into like scarecrow stuff and stuff like that. Now these males can literally get up to size to breed in less than a year. So if you were to invest in this animal, you could then take it back to some of the other animals, whether it's a spot-nosed head clown, or you could take it to some of the other females. Then you can produce scarecrows, which can go for several $1,000s, and all kinds of other combinations. And you could do it pretty quick because you have all those females you're raising up, as well as the original spot-nosed head clown. So now you have maybe the opportunity to produce 4, 5, 6 clutches that are all gonna be different clowns, and you're adding pastel to the gene, as well as the banana, which really makes things awesome. And you can really tell some of these babies are gonna start to be absolute rippers. This happens to be a pastel lesser leopard clown ball python. And just take a look at that beauty here. So now you're producing heat, man, right? Every baby you're producing is worth $2,000, $3,000, $4,000, $5,000, sometimes even more. So that's what you're trying to do, is build on stuff, right? You're stacking genes and you're trying to produce better and better animals that are not only gonna be more beautiful, but also high, high demand for them, right? And right now there's no more high demand other than the clown project and all of these things that I'm talking about now. So now you're into year 3, maybe 4, and you're really starting to hit some stuff, right? Now you might be producing $25,000 to $40,000 worth of snakes. I would still hang on to the females that you really want to work with to continue to expand, and then go ahead and sell off the males, except for the ones that you really want to add into the project. And now you're well on your way. Like I said, you're about halfway to your goal of $100,000. Just to show you a few things that you're going to be producing during this time, even something like a lesser leopard clown ball python is absolutely ridiculous. I mean, look at the reduction of pattern, all that type of stuff. So you're going to be producing tons of heat. I mean, every baby you're producing now is just going to be amazing. The hardest part you're going to be totally honest with you, is to decide what to sell and what to keep, right? We're trying to reach that goal of $100,000, so you can't keep it all. If it was up to me, I would just keep everything, to be honest with you. Woo, this little guy's a little feisty monkey. But the truth is, every baby you're going to be hatching is going to be absolutely ridiculous. Take, for instance, you've got that pastel gene in there, right? So you're going to be producing pastel lesser leopard clown ball pythons. This one happens to have a paradox blotching on it, which makes it a little bit more desirable, adds a little bit of value to it. The truth is, it just looks really cool. But as they get bigger, they're actually very interesting animals too. But listen, you can take a little divergence in the meantime if you don't want to just stick to this path. Really inexpensively, with a little bit of that offspring, you could add, let's say, Mojave to it. And when you add that Mojave to it, it really changes stuff. This is actually a banana Mojave clown ball python, and just absolutely wonderful. So again, you can layer things on, and a Mojave head clown or a Mojave clown isn't that expensive. So with some of the proceeds you're making to add that gene to it, it just gives you more options, right? And more ideas to get into different layering, right? And this could be an animal that could eventually produce something that's worth $5,000 or $10,000 if you're putting it into all the other genes, like the spot nose and the leopard. And then you have the pastel in there, and then maybe you even add like an entry gene. You know, there's anything you can possibly do from here, because you've made a little bit of money, you've got a bunch of holdback animals, your group is probably up to maybe 40 animals at this point, so you have to make sure you have the rack space for it, you have to have the rodents for it and stuff like that, so there will be a little bit of expenses, but you do have a little bit of money to reinvest into the next thing. And again, there's a fine line between spending too much of your money, reinvesting enough, but you have to continue to grow to get to that $100,000 mark. This happens to be a pastel lesser bongo enchi het for clown ball python. This would work perfectly in your group, right? Because now you've got enchi in there, you've got bongo in there, you've got the pastel for the super pastel stuff with some of the other animals you have. Of course, it's gonna add banana into it. You've got the spot nose to go into it, the leopard to go into it. I mean, it's endless, right? Now you've got all kinds of genes to not only produce stuff that's already being produced, but maybe produce some things that haven't been produced then. And that's when the real big money happens, because let's say you hit a banana, lesser, enchi, bongo, lesser, spot nose, clown ball python. I mean, that's going to be a $10,000 or $12,000 snake, and you're really getting your way to the top right here. And again, I don't want to continue to say like these animals are worth money, because like I said, I don't really breed stuff for the money these days, but I'm still working on projects that I'm really super excited about, and they do bring revenue in. And if you want to work with animals and like, hey, listen, I don't care about the money, but I want to make the money so that I can continue to work with animals, I'm just trying to give you a basic outline of what I would do. And again, there's many different ways you can go. This isn't the only way you can go. You can work with other genes, you can do whatever. I'm just giving you a basic outline of what I would do if I wanted to go from $1,000 to $100,000. You guys know I typically talk about the reptarium, I talk about animal education and stuff like that, but I want to know from you guys, do you like this kind of content? Do you want me to get more in depth in it? I could actually go over on my Patreon, link in the description, and we could get really deep into the business side, not only of breeding reptiles, but also anything to do with animals, supplies, reptile zoo, whatever you might want to do. If you do like it, you know, hit me up in the comments, let me know, join my Patreon, and we can actually really dive deep. You've got to remember, 35 years I've done this as a profession, so I definitely have had some experience with it. I've had ups, I've had downs, but I've certainly been through a lot, and I'm happy to help you guys along your way. So let me know what you guys think, and if you do want to do it, we can certainly do it over on Patreon. Another thing you can add in to kind of darken things up, because right now there's a lot of interest in the darker clown ball pythons, like the stranger gene and stuff like that. You can get into mahoganies, right? This is actually a mahogany leopard that is het for clown ball python. Again, now you're looking at another gene, you start adding to it, and it doesn't cost you that much to get into this type of stuff. You just start to continue to add to your arsenal of different genetics that you've got going on. Because like I said, now that you have 40, 50 animals, maybe you have 8 or 10 males and the rest are females, you have a lot of things to breed into, and you're gonna start producing 10, 15, 20, 25, 30 clutches before you know it. And now you're really starting to stack genetics. Now this is where you're gonna take the biggest diversion for what we've been doing. Up until now, we've been producing a bunch of het clown stuff, right? Different incomplete dominants, things that are gonna add to clown. Now I'm gonna get into the second recessive mutation, right? Now I'll be totally honest with you, I don't even work with these, so I don't actually have one to show you, but this is actually a piebald ball python. The truth is, I would go ahead and take some money. It's gonna cost you a few, maybe $3,500 to $5,000 to buy a clown pied ball python. Now, I would buy a male clown pied ball python, then you can start breeding that into other mutations of clowns, and that means you're gonna get all clowns that are het for pied, right? So all the combinations that you're producing now, the scarecrow, the Batman, everything that you're producing now of clown is also gonna be carrying the pied gene. That adds a different layer. Now that's when you grow these up, you're gonna be producing pied clown combos of all those things. Again, it's gonna take you a couple years to get these things rolling, but this is going to be an amazing thing to add to it, because right now the two recessive mutations that are really, really, really popular are the clown ball python and the pie ball python. So I would definitely add the pies into it, because it is going to really send your project to the moon. So I would say you're into year 5 at this point, to be totally honest with you, and you're probably already producing somewhere between $50,000 and $70,000 worth of snakes per year. Now you're investing some of it into, you know, infrastructure, feeding, all that type of stuff, and you're also investing into things like the pie clown. found. So you're not making that money, but you're making some money. There's no doubt about it, but you're about to make really good things when the next generation comes in. It's gonna take you 2 more years. So you're about year 6 is when things are gonna really, really hit for you. And that's when you're gonna make that $100,000. But one thing to keep in mind is it's important that you're enjoying the process, right? You know, again, I'm going through this video just because so many people have asked me to do it. But the truth is if you're not enjoying every step of the way, it's not worth the money, to be totally honest with you. And at least for me, when I'm producing things like this super pastel lesser leopard clown ball python, it's never about the money. When they hatch out, I don't ever think what they cost. I just think, oh my gosh, that is a beautiful snake. And the truth is it's hard for me to want to sell any of them because they're so darn beautiful. So enjoy the process, right? By now you're really producing some amazing animals and you're really getting a name out there probably, and you're starting to really make some money. But at the same time, don't ever do it for the money, because if you're doing it for the money, you're really not doing the animal any justice at all. And I don't want to see anyone get into these animals just for the money side. That being said, if you're really passionate about it and you want to do it, the money for me is always just about being able to get more animals or to expand the zoo or do something like that. But the truth is, just enjoy every minute of it because it's freaking awesome. Before we move on, I want to give you a couple pro tips that's going to help you along your way, because the truth is that I'm giving you kind of the outline of what I would buy animal-wise and how I would expand. But the real truth is you're a business now, right? So as a business, conduct yourself as a business, right? Make sure you get on social media. Make sure you have an Instagram, you have a YouTube channel, have a Twitter, you have a TikTok, and make sure you're putting that content out there and also representing your company in a professional way, right? Because if you're not doing it professionally, people aren't gonna wanna spend $5,000 with you or $10,000 with you, right? So it's about image as well. You know, guys like Justin Kabelica, Miguel, Ozzy Boyd, the list goes on and on. These guys are presenting themselves super professional. So when they have these $5,000, $10,000, $15,000 snakes, people feel comfortable dealing with them. Because again, your business is gonna be super important for your success, right? And that means standing behind your customers. Make sure your service is great, because listen, everybody can have snakes for sale, but if your service and the way you treat your customers is great, you're gonna stand out and you're gonna be super, super successful. So make sure you're thinking business-minded as well as how much you're enjoying the animals, because if not, you're still not gonna be successful. Back to snakes, and the fact is that you guys are gonna be producing some heat by now. You're gonna have a beautiful collection of maybe, you know, 50, 60 animals, maybe up to 100 animals that are all incredible, that are either visual clowns, visual pies, or a bunch of really cool het stuff that you're gonna wanna keep. Now, to be totally honest with you, by this time you may wanna start getting rid of some of your earlier animals if you don't want too many, because they won't be as much. That original founder stock of the spot-nosed heck clown, she may not be that valuable for you as far as keeping. Now, for me, I don't look at it that way. I wanna keep them because I think they're absolutely wonderful animals. But the fact is that it is important to really put your time into the right animals, right? And the fact is you can take this, the same thing I'm doing now with the clowns and the pies, put it into any other project. If you want lavender albinos, use lavender albinos and do the same type of thing. You could do it just with piebald ball pythons. You could do it with monsoons, desert ghosts, you name it. You could use this kind of template and actually use it towards other projects if clown isn't the way you wanna go, or clown pie isn't the way you wanna go. But the fact is that if you use the template and you work hard at it, you can actually turn $1,000 into $100,000. Trust me, I've seen a lot of people do it. And you always gotta keep your eyes on the prize, right? There's gonna be a day where you're sitting here 6 years into your project and you've got a clutch of eggs like this, 14 eggs in this clutch right now. And maybe this is the clutch you've been waiting for and the genetics have to be perfect. And maybe there's 3 or 4 world's first animals in here, but there's certainly gonna be some bangers because the genetics you're breeding now are absolute rippers, right? I'm telling you, when you're into year 6, if you do everything right, that's the year that you're gonna turn that $1,000 into $100,000, and it's gonna be absolutely amazing. And again, for me, it's not about the money. For you, I hope it's not about the money, but this is a template if you wanna go in this direction, because if your passion is to work with animals and to breed snakes and stuff like that, this is the way you can actually do it, and you can be successful, and you can look at not only myself, but so many other people that have used this similar template, and within 4, 5, 6 years, they actually become super successful. Now, the truth is if you have $10,000 to start with, or $100,000 to start with, you're gonna get there a lot quicker, because we've certainly seen people do that have been able to sink a lot more money in, and within 3 or 4 years, they're already at the mark that you wanna get to. But this is the way, if you don't have a lot of money, and when you have these eggs, you're gonna be sitting here one day, and you're gonna be like, I finally made it, and it's an incredible feeling. So I hope that this helps you if you decide you wanna follow your passion, and you wanna breed snakes, or you wanna work with animals. I wanna continue to reiterate that I don't breed snakes really for money anymore, but I wanted to show my experience, the last 35 years of experience and show you what I would do to help you guys out. So let me know in the comments if you like this. If you did like this video, here's some egg cutting videos for you when you're egg cutting these animals. Over here, do me a favor, hit that subscription button. Hope you guys have a wonderful day, Reptile Army. Remember, be kind to somebody, and I promise I'll see you in the next one.